Kevin of Loxley knows a little something about thievery, so today he brought with him Bank Heist for your Atari and Sears video game systems. And check that out. Gas, only 18 cents a gallon. That is a steal. Let's go ahead and take Bank Heist. Let's pop it in my Atari and Sears video game systems and see how it holds up today. Let's go to the game. Bank Heist was published by 20th Century Fox and carries a copyright year of 1983. It was programmed by Bill Aspromonte, who also programmed the impressive Stargate for the 2600, which I reviewed in episode 258. The manual opens with the following. Your goal is to rob as many banks as possible before running out of getaway cars. Disabling cop cars with dynamite increases your score and causes more banks to appear in the town. Running into cop cars or accidentally dynamiting your own car will abruptly halt your little joy ride. Bank Heist is a maze game for one player only and allows you to start at one of eight difficulty levels. For the controls, you use the joystick to move and press the button to release a stick of dynamite from behind you. The goal of each maze is to rob as many banks as possible before moving on to the next maze. Up to three banks show up on screen at a time. To rob them, you simply drive over them, but once you do, a cop car will show up. You start with four spare cars as shown in the upper right corner, but you lose a car if you crash into a cop, blow yourself up with your own dynamite, or if you run out of gas as shown in the upper left. When cops are chasing you, you could destroy them with your dynamite. If you do, a new bank will show up for you to rob. Every time you rob a bank, not only will you get some points, but at times a line on the right of the gas tank will rise, showing you the amount of fuel you'll get when you leave that maze and go on to the next. If you are able to rob 9 banks before leaving, you will get a full tank of gas and an extra getaway car. Each maze represents a town and has 4 exit tunnels, 2 on the right and 2 on the left. The 2 on the left and the bottom one on the right side wrap around to the other side, but the one on the top right sends you to the next town. Once you leave a town, you can't go back. Leave 4 towns and you start back at the first at a higher difficulty. Scoring wise, you get $10 for the first bank, $20 for the second, $30 for the third, $40 for the fourth, $50 for the fifth, $60 for the sixth, $70 for the seventh, $80 for the eighth, and $90 for the ninth bank and above. When you leave a town, the point value for the banks reverts back to $10 starting with the first. If you destroy a cop car with dynamite, if only one cop car is in pursuit of you at the time, you will get $10. If 2 cop cars are chasing you, you will get $30 for blowing one up. And if 3 are pursuing you, you will get $50 for blowing up a cop car. If you're able to rob 9 banks before leaving a town, you will get some bonus cash. Starting at the easiest difficulty, when you leave the first town of Bankersfield, you will get $93. When you leave the second town of Silver Dollar, you will get $186. When you leave the third town of Flat Broke, you will get $279. And when you leave the final town of Heist Town, you will get $372. For every difficulty level you increase, the town value will go up $372. The difficulty switches also can affect the game. When the left difficulty switch is in the B position, the cops are not that smart and they go in more of a set pattern, but in the A position, they are smarter and will always try to find you. When the right difficulty switch is in the B position, banks will appear in a set order, but they will be randomized in the A position. Graphically speaking, there really isn't much to the game. Most of the sounds are also pretty basic, although I do like the siren sound. Family-friendly wise, even though you are robbing banks, the game would most likely get an E for Everyone rating if released today, or possibly an E10 and up rating since you are blowing up cop cars. At the time I researched on eBay, including shipping, loose copies were going for $12 to $20, one complete copy sold for $39, and new copies were going for $62 to $74. So what did I think of Bank Heist? While I'm not a fan of being a bad guy in a game, I must admit that as a maze game, Bank Heist is pretty solid and a refreshing take on the maze game style. Placing dynamite can be tricky, but overall the game controls fairly well. I also liked how the game shakes out the maze formula by adding the ability to use and earn fuel, and how it rewards you for robbing enough banks before moving on to the next town. Overall, I had a lot of fun with this one, and I could see myself playing it again. So where am I going to rank Bank Heist? This one is going in the 40s. I do like Stargate more at 46, but I will put this over SeaQuest at 47. So out of the 190 games I've now ranked on the Atari 2600, Bank Heist is holding up the 47 position. Bank Heist is a hidden gem of a maze game on the 2600, but that's just my opinion. What do you think? Let me know in the comments below. Also, please like, share, and subscribe. Follow me both on the Facebook and the Twitter. Check out some of my many other videos and sign up at patreon.com/nosweargamer, just like Caleb did, to support the show and gain access to exclusive perks. Thank you for giving me a little part of your day, and I look forward to seeing you next time on the next episode of the No Swear Gamer. Take care, especially when dropping dynamite out of your car.